welcome back to my channel. This is the first YouTube video I've filmed in about 6 months, so I'm definitely feeling a little bit awkward, so ignore that if I do come across as awkward. But yeah, had a little bit of a break. I think the last video I filmed was probably April time. It's been a long while. COVID happened. I know you've all probably heard like way too much about that, so we won't even delve into it. Been a pretty crazy 6 months, but I figured it's my time of year, gals. It's autumn, winter. I thought, what better of a video to come back with than a massive Primark haul? And I mean, Ella's FaceTiming me. Be right back. Okay, now Ella's off FaceTime. Yeah, I've literally got about 3 bags worth of stuff to update my autumn winter wardrobe, and I thought I would show you guys what I've got. So let's get straight into it. So I'm just gonna take things out in no particular order because I can't even remember what I've bought at this point. It's a bit ridiculous. Okay, first thing I got was some leather look leggings. I don't own any of these. I feel like they've been a trend for literally like 4 years by this point, and I've never had any. So I thought I'd try some. These are just in the size small, which I think is a 10 to 12. Yeah, a 10 to 12. Let me take the hanger off. And they're just kind of, I don't know, just your basic leather look leggings, I guess. They were £10, which I didn't think was that bad of a price. They've got like a hem down the middle of each leg, if you can see that. But I'll try them on anyways, and I'll put a clip in for you guys to see them. But yeah, I thought for £10, you can't really complain with them. I was really happy with them. I don't know whether I'll like them. I'm sure you'll see in the try on clip. But yeah, first thing. Next thing I got was this jumper dress. It's this nice cream colour. I really like it. I think I had to get it in a size extra small, which is a 6 to 8, which wasn't ideal. I wanted to get like a small or a medium because I wanted it to be kind of oversized, but the sizes they had in, they literally either had like an extra small or a large, so I think the large would have been too big. But it's got a roll neck, it's really pretty, and then it's just got this like cable knit pattern on it. Really cute. So I thought this would look really nice with a pair of leggings underneath it and some chunky boots kind of thing. So that's the vibe I was going for with that anyway. But you guys will have seen the try on clip by now. And this was £15, which I thought was a little bit pricey, but then I'm a cheapskate, so I don't know whether that is or not. Ah, the hangers come off. Next, I got this cardigan. I just thought this looked really cozy, and I don't have... Right, so Ella, my best friend, she just FaceTimed me. She has cardigans that you can just sit in and like be all comfy and cozy and, you know, all that jazz. And I don't, so I wanted one. So that was who I thought of when I got this. But this cardigan was £13. Yeah, £13. I got it in a size small. And my idea for this is just to kind of wear it over things. It was like leggings and a t-shirt and some trainers, just if you're going out running errands and stuff. I just think it looks really slouchy and comfy, so that was that. Then next I got these leggings. Oh my god, if you've never owned a pair of these leggings you get from Primark, get some. These are the velvet plush faux fur lined leggings. I bought a pair of these in black, which I've still got for when we went to New York, and I literally wore them the whole trip because they are the warmest things you've ever witnessed in your life. So they're fur lined like that, and these are just in a grey colour because I've already got the black pair. They're just the best. Like, for cold winter days to wear under dresses, they're perfect because they kind of look like tights. But yeah, £6, can't really go wrong. And they wash really well as well. I kind of thought that because of the faux like fur lining, they wouldn't wash very well, but they're perfect. And it's on here, the warmest leggings you will ever wear, and I'd agree. I'll agree with you there, Primark, they are fantastic. So next I got another jumper, and I just thought this was really pretty. I don't actually know whether I like it as much now as I did when I saw it in the shop, I'm not sure. But it's just got this really cute collar, and it's got the same on the sleeves. And it's like this beigey colour, I don't know how to describe it. But I just thought this would look really nice with the leather look leggings and some boots. I got it in a size small, which is a 10 to 12, and it was £13. So, and it's not too thick, that's what I liked about it. I thought, because sometimes I'll wear a really thick jumper and it's just too hot, and I didn't think you'd get that with this, so that was my idea behind buying that. Then next I got this skirt. Now I'm not normally a skirt person, so this is a bit of a adventurous buy for me, and it's a mini skirt as well, which is completely not like me, but it's a woolen mini skirt and it was £10. I got it in a size small, but yeah, I just think it'll look really nice with kind of a jumper and some boots for like an autumn walk or something, or a day out or brunch. Not like I have anyone to go to brunch with, but yeah, that's that. That was £10. I got this roll neck jumper. Well, I don't really know if it's a jumper or a top. I'd say it's probably more of a top, but these are fantastic. They're only £6. This is in a size medium because I wanted it to be slightly oversized, which is a size 12 to 14. And like I say, it was £6, roll neck, in this nice sort of like beigey colour. And I love it. You'll see it better when I try it on. I just thought this would be great tucked into things for layering with like a big nice coat. I just thought it'd be fantastic. I didn't get to buy any coats in Primark actually, which was one thing I wanted to do because Primark's coats are like the best. And then last but not least, clothing wise, this is probably my favourite thing that I picked up, I'm not gonna lie. It's this skirt. It's like a long skirt. It's like this, I don't know what pattern you call that plaid, but it's got this belt, and I just thought this would look amazing with like a jumper tucked into it, some chunky boots or something like that, and like a wraparound coat. I thought it looked really, really good. I got it in a size 10 and it was £15. Yeah, so that was the last I think I got clothing wise. Everything else was just kind of when you're in Primark you have to pick it up, so I'm gonna go through that with you guys next. I bought a beret. Can't say I've ever wore a beret, but I saw them and I just thought, do you know what, I'll buy a beret. £4, so not that expensive. I don't even know how you wear them. Like, does that go on the back of your head? I don't know. I don't know how I'm gonna wear this. I've never wore a beret in my life, unless my mum made me wear one at some point when I was younger. I don't know. So yeah, my forehead might be too big for it, who knows, but I'll find a way around trying to wear it. So yeah, got that. Then next I got this little bag. I really, really liked it. It's just like a little, chucking it around the place. I don't know what style these are. I couldn't tell you, but it's like a faux snake print. It was reduced from £8 to £4. So I was like, that's a bargain for a little bag. And I don't have many in between size bags. I tend to have either tiny ones that I can only fit my phone in, or huge ones that I can fit everything but the kitchen sink in. So I thought this would be a perfect like in between, and I feel like it comes with a strap as well, so you can wrap it around the front of you. I think it will go with so many outfits, so I was really happy when I got that. Then next I got some gloves. These were only £1 and look at how cute they are. They're like this pink colour. They're super, super soft. I absolutely love them. Let me check they fit. I didn't do that in the shop because they had different sizes. Yeah, they fit. And they just feel so warm and cozy. And I don't really have a pair of gloves that I wear all the time, if that makes sense. So I thought these would come in really handy. Handy. Do you get it? Gloves. Oh, that's really bad. But then I got some socks. I'm always stealing Reese's trainer socks, so when we were in there he was like, you need to get some trainer socks so you stop stealing mine. So I got 7 pairs for £2.50, and I thought these were actually quite nice. They're like patterned, well at least I think only literally one pair is, yeah. But yeah, you can't really go wrong, 7 pairs for £2.50, all really neutral colours as well. And then my friend Emily had these socks. Cozy socks. They're not fluffy socks, they're cozy socks. So they're the same material as like the gloves, but it just makes your feet feel really like soft and warm. And I'm probably going to wear these tonight after I've got out of my shower, not going to lie. So yeah, 2 pairs for £2.50, which I didn't think was too bad. Slightly more expensive than their fluffy socks they do, but yeah, I'm hoping they might last a bit longer than the fluffy socks because they feel better made. Then I got some new winter slippers. I absolutely love Primark slippers. At the minute I have like the slider fluffy ones, but because it's getting into winter my feet are getting a bit cold, so I thought I'd get some full memory foam ones. These have just got this like sparkly pattern on, they're super cute, and they're only £4, which I thought was an absolute bargain. I've just realised I actually picked up the wrong size. We've got a 5 to 6 and my feet are like a size 4, So they're probably going to be super big, but that doesn't matter. I'd rather them be big than too small. So that is really comfy. Can't wait to put them on either. Next, I got some scrunchies because I literally wear scrunchies all the time. My idea behind these ones was that I can wear them to bed because they're really soft. I don't know whether you can see. And some of the like velvety ones that I've got, is it velvet? Yeah, like they're not very soft. So when I'm trying to sleep on them, they're stuck in the side of my head. These might be just as uncomfortable, but I thought I'd give them a try. If not, they're really cute colours anyway, so I can wear them to work and stuff like that. Then we got a load of face masks because Reese just was chucking them in the trolley without asking me. So yeah, we got them, but I'll go through the ones that we got. So we got some soothing vitamin E eye patches. I've had these before. You get 15 treatments, so there's like 30 patches in here for £1, which is really good. You just literally pop them on your under eyes and it just gives them like a refresh, and they're actually pretty good. So I'd actually really recommend them. For £1, you can't really go wrong with 15 treatments. Then next we've got this tiger grass one. It's a rebalancing mask. It says it balances redness and it helps improve skin appearance. There's two applications in here for £1.50. That's not too bad either, actually, is it? I've not even had a look at these until I've just got them out of the bag. Then this one was £1.50 as well, and it's got three different masks in it. So there's a pink clay one, a white clay one, and a green clay one. And I think what you do is put the different masks in different parts of your face. So this top one's for your T-zone, the middle one's for your C-zone, and then the green one's for your U-zone. I don't know, but it's put like little pictures of where it needs to go on your face. So that'll be a good one to give a try. I don't know which ones of these Reese is planning on donating to me, but I'll be sure to let you guys know once I've used one and if they're any good. The last face mask is this deep cleansing Kakadu. This deep cleansing Kakadu plum cream mask. It was 80p, so. And then last but not least, we've got some charcoal nose strips. So you get 5 nose strips for £1, which is so cheap compared to the Bior ones that you can get. I haven't tried these, so I don't know whether they're any good, but I know a lot of the cheaper ones I've tried aren't anywhere near as good as the Bior ones, so I'll be sure to let you guys know whether these are actually any good or not. But if they are, it's definitely a much cheaper alternative to the ones that we normally buy. I think they can be like £6 a box, the Bior ones, which is really expensive for just like a pore strip, so yeah. And then last but not least, we got some wardrobe room sachets. I think these are meant to be like just put in a room somewhere, but we like to put them in our wardrobes to make the wardrobe smell really nice. So Reese got the lavender silk one, and then I got the peony and rose one, and these were £1.50 each, and they just make all your clothes smell really nice and fresh, and they're really good, to be fair. It says last up to 4 weeks, but I think my last one lasted a bit longer than that, in all honesty, so can't complain. And that is everything. I definitely spent more money than I should have done, but I 100% needed some new autumny winter things to add into my wardrobe, so it was definitely worth a trip to Primark. If you did like anything that I bought, please let me know what your favourite was. I'm really interested to see what you guys think. And yeah, if you did enjoy the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. I am hoping to make a lot more content in the next coming weeks, a lot of autumn content, so please stay tuned for that. And I will see you guys next time. Thank you for watching.